Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Beacon Live. This is Daniel Chia, and I'm Miss Lu. And we're here. We have two guests tonight, musical guests, as well as a charity called Care Channels International, who will come on very soon. And we hope everyone's doing well, wherever you're tuning in from, even if you're watching this in the future, after the live stream has ended, we hope you're well. And we would like to, you know, jump into the comments, actually, to say hi to some of the people who are already here.
Yeah, we have Daryl. Nice to see you, Daryl. Thank you so much. We have Michelle commenting from the laptop.
Hello.
So Michelle is on laptop duty at the start before she comes on later. And yeah, let's see who else.
Oh, we have Imelda saying, "I love you, Sharon," with two hearts. Where's the love for Kevin, though?
No need.
Oh, come. No need. Okay, she gave two hearts anyway, so enough to share. We have Tony Smith II saying, "Hello, guys, from Pasadena, California. Hello, good morning,
hey, Tony.
I guess. Good morning.
We have Jazzy from the US as well. Nice to see you. And Vinny as well. So quite a lot of US friends who are just getting awake.
Yes, we hope that, you know, this will start your day off on the right note, even as you're getting ready and things like that. Put this on. The music will really, it has blessed me at soundcheck, so I hope it will bless you too. Yeah.
Vinny says, "I hope I can listen as much as I can at work." Yes. I'm sure your boss will forgive you.
Work from home.
Yeah, work from home, right?
We have Chris Chua here.
Oh,
thanks so much,
Chris.
Thanks for being a sponsor and great supporter of this Beacon Live series.
Yeah, so if for the viewers who are tuning in for the first time, this entire Beacon Live series is actually sponsored by Eden Resources. So a big thank you to Chris Chua, Eden Resources. And also, equipment is supported by Blackmagic and Audio-Technica. So a big thank you to the sponsors out there. We really appreciate you.
Let's see who else we have. We have Eric. Nice to see you, Eric.
Hello, Eric. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I think this might be a good time for us to introduce our guests to you who are already here, ready, raring to go. And I'm just going to read a little bit of what they prepared for us. So on guitar and vocals today is Kevin, and Sharon is on keys and backup vocals, but very soft.
Very backup.
Very backup for the backup. So Kevin and Sharon have been playing music for as long as they can remember. Both were passionately involved in music ministry in their formative years, and contemporary Christian music was a large influence. So tonight, they will be sharing some CCM tunes that they love, each chosen for its purpose in the current season. Can't wait for the audience to hear what you've prepared, both the stories and the songs. Yeah.
So today's style is slightly different. Mm. We have two sets of music from Kevin and Sharon, and in between, we will have a sharing session by CCI. So yeah, something different that we're trying out tonight. So hope you guys will enjoy this first set of performance, and but maybe before we let them start the music, we should hear a bit more from Kevin and Sharon.
Sorry,
about
we should spend more time together before
we
go.
Yeah.
You can call us Karen.
Kevin and Sharon. Karen.
Okay, maybe we shall start with Kevin. You know, were you always a Christian?
No, actually, I was a converted. I'm a Catholic. Mm. Yeah, what drew me to church was actually music.
Mm.
Yeah, I would sit next to the band and I would write down the lyrics. Yeah, and
then
yeah, that drew me to God, like in conversations.
Oh,
down
that's
the road.
Beautiful.
That's amazing. And how about Sharon?
I was born Catholic, so it was very interesting when I met Kevin.
How you remember? Oh no.
Oh,
no way. So it was very interesting when I met Kevin, because he's not, right? I mean, he was a convert. And a lot of things that I took for granted, he found, you know, so meaningful. Mm. So that was quite special. Yeah.
It's wonderful.
Yeah.
Really can't wait to hear the rest of the story in between the songs, you know. And for the people out there, there will be lyrics on screen. So if you know some of these tunes, you can sing along. But if you don't, we hope that you'll be able to understand the songs more deeply through the lyrics as well.
You know, just now Kevin was saying that he would sit down and write down the lyrics.
Yeah.
Right? I would sit down, but I would write it on chords.
Perfect match then, Karen.
So that's quite interesting.
That's wonderful. Yeah.
Yeah. And Sharon, actually, I'm not sure if you remember this or I told you before, but my first time I knew of you was in a Christian competition when you were a judge at the flyer. Oh, I didn't tell you before, is it?
No, no, you didn't tell me.
It was, this is at least...
Very many years ago.
15 years ago. Can I make it 10? Not
15. Don't give
away. 10 years ago. So yeah, I think that was like the first. I can't even remember what was it or organized by who or what. Yeah, so that was just 10 years ago. So not so bad. Yeah.
I'm only 16.
Child prodigy then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. So I think we will leave Kevin and Sharon to share more through their music, and hope you guys will enjoy this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Fall like drops of rain. My lips are like clouds. I say so many things, trying to figure you out. As mercy opens my eyes, and my words are stolen away, with this breathtaking view of your grace. And I am speechless, I'm astonished and amazed. I am silenced by your wondrous grace. You have saved me, you have raised me from the grave. I am speechless in your presence now. I'm astounded as I consider how you have shown us love that leaves us speechless. What kind of love could this be that would trade hands thrown for a cross? And to think you still celebrate over finding just one who was lost. Know you rejoice over us that caught up this whole universe. It's a story that's too great for words. And I am speechless, I'm astonished and amazed. I am silenced by your wondrous grace. You have saved me, you have raised me from the grave. I am speechless in your presence now. I'm astounded as I consider how you have shown us a love that leaves us speechless. We are speechless. Oh, how great is the love the Father has lavished upon us, that we should be called sons and daughters of God. Stand in awe of your grace. We stand in awe of your mercy. We stand in awe of your love. We are speechless.
One of my favorite Bible verses comes from 1 John chapter 3. How great is the love the Father has lavished upon each of us, that we are sons and daughters of God. So that always amazes me, that kind of wide, unconditional love. Let's sing this together.
We stand in awe of your grace. We stand in awe of your mercy. We stand in awe of your love. We are speechless. We stand in awe of your cross. We stand in awe of your power. We are speechless. We stand in awe of your grace. We stand in awe of your mercy. We stand in awe of your love. We stand in awe of your love. We are speechless. We are speechless. We stand in awe of your cross. We stand in awe of your power. We are speechless. We are speechless. We are speechless. We are speechless. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Once again, if you just joined us, my name is Kevin. This is my lovely wife back here.
I got a lovely today.
Lovely wife.
He doesn't usually say that.
I do. You never hear any. Yeah, oh, by the way, she's Sharon. Sharon Nunis on piano.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us tonight. We're very happy to be here because these are songs that mean so much to us. We've kind of grown up with these songs. Actually, we started in music ministry, in different ministries. Some would say rival ministries, if there's such a thing. So our offices were next to each other. But somehow, I think that time we were playing a lot of more like praise and worship music. And I still remember like people like Don Moen really inspiring me. And we would listen, we would listen to Abraham Laboriel and all that. But then suddenly my ears got opened when I like encountered contemporary Christian music. So people like, just now that song, Speechless, was by Stephen Curtis Chapman, one of our heroes. And tonight, we are very happy to be here because we get to share so many beautiful CCM songs with you by people like Stephen Curtis Chapman and Chris Rice and groups like Watermark, Christy Knuckles, yeah?
These songs are called Christian Contemporary Music, also known as CCM.
CCM, that's right.
They sound a bit different.
Different flavor, different flavor from the praise and worship music. Because I think a lot of times it tells more of a story rather than just being like a direct prayer. Mm-hmm. So anyway, the next song that we have for you tonight is also one of our favorites. Interestingly enough, he had one CD by Chris Rice, and I had the other CD by Chris Rice, and nobody else we knew had any Chris Rice CDs.
That was when we were teenagers dating.
I think haven't date yet.
Haven't
so
date
it was
yet,
like our first, wow, like maybe there's something, you know, to to look at here. So anyway, the next song is called Deep Enough to Dream by Chris Rice. And it talks about a guy, it's like a hot summer's afternoon, you know, so he kicks off his shoes and he's kind of like lounging around. And then slowly, because it's so hot, he starts to like, you know, fall into a kind of a slumber. And then in his slumber, he starts to dream, and he dreams about what heaven would be like. And it's very interesting because it's all the colors and just this beautiful vision of heaven. And then he kind of like doesn't want to wake up. You know, do I really have to wake up, he says, to come back into the real world.
Actually, in verse 2 also, there's this, he writes about a metaphor of a fly buzzing around, trapped in his insect screen trying to get out to the other side. Mm. Yeah, nice metaphor.
Yeah, I think it's also like a nice metaphor because it's like us, right? We're kind of like in this world, trapped in this world, and we are kind of longing, you know, to see what's on the other side. So this song is for you.
I just want to mention C.S. Lewis.
Okay.
If I find in myself desires which nothing in this world can satisfy, the only logical explanation is that I was made for another world. Lazy summer afternoon, screened in porch and nothing to do. I just kicked off my tennis shoes, slouching in a plastic chair. raking my fingers through my hair. I close my eyes and I leave them there, and I yawn and sigh and slowly fade away. Deep enough to dream in brilliant colors I have never seen. Deep enough to join a billion people for a wedding feast. Deep enough to reach out and touch the face of the one who made me. Oh, the love I feel and all the peace. Do I ever have to wake up? Awakened by a familiar sound. Clumsy flyers buzzing around. He bumps the screen and he tumbles down. Gathers about his wits and pride. He tries again for the 100th time. Cause freedom calls from the other side. And I smile and nod and slowly drift away. Deep enough to dream in brilliant colors I have never seen. Deep enough to join a billion people for a wedding feast. Deep enough to reach out and touch the face of the one who made me. Oh, the love I feel and all the peace. Do I ever have to wake up? Cause peace is flowing over my soul. See the lambs and the lions playing. Joining and I drink the music. Holiness is the air I'm breathing. My faithful heroes break the bread and answers all of my questions. Not to mention what the streets are made of. My heart's held hostage by this love. And these brilliant colors I have never seen. I join a billion people for a wedding feast. I reach out and touch the face of the one who made me. Deep enough to dream in brilliant colors I have never seen. Deep enough to join a billion people for a wedding feast. Deep enough to reach out and touch the face of the one who made me. Deep enough to dream in brilliant colors I have never seen. I join a billion people for a wedding feast. I reach out and touch the face of the one who made me. Oh, the love I feel and know the peace. Do I ever have to wake up? Do I really have to wake up? Do I really have to wake up?
That was deep enough to dream.
Sorry, unfamiliar keyboard.
As long as you don't have to come out, Kennedy.
Quiet in my heart. so quick to move instead of listening to you. Shut my mouth, crush my pride, give me the tears of a broken life. Still, of this world that falls around, flutters all its beauty in my eyes. But let me choose the solitude. Simplicity is always simply change my life. And even stillness makes a move, 'cause that's when my heart learns to dance with you. Still, let me be still. Let me be okay with the quiet in my heart. Still, I want to be still. I'm so quick to move instead of listening to you.
A song called Still by Watermark.
So the next song that we have for you talks about first love. Can you all remember your first love?
Sharon's first love is very violent, I think.
Oh, yeah. My first love was in kindergarten. Woo-hoo! I think his first love was also in kindergarten. I think it was this like little Chinese boy, and then we would always wait for a school bus at the same bus stop. And then we were like, oh, boyfriend, girlfriend. But then one day he irritated me on the bus. So I kind of punched him. And then that was the end of the relationship. Ta-da!
That's why I'm very careful, you know, in my marriage life. Someone should got a lot of knives in the kitchen.
That's right. Be very careful. Yeah, because he bullied me, ma, so I must punch him. Anyway, so the
That was a boyfriend knife you just joined us.
yeah, not him. So the next song, it talks about first love, you know how initially when we meet our first love and then everything is la-di-da and good, and then we go around carving our initials on everything that we can find. Don't do this, okay? But that's what we usually do. This song talks about first love that grows from there and reminds us actually that, oh, this first love is actually God, what, right? He's actually supposed to be our first love. And more than him being our first love, actually, he was the one who first loved us, you know. And you know how we carve our initials into everything, and he carved our names into the tree. The tree is the cross that Jesus bore for us out of the great love that God has for you and for me. So this is My Tree by Chris Rice.
Stands a tall, mighty tree, where a boy and girl used to take turns pushing the tire swing. I remember the pocket knife in hand and her name in my heart, and thinking there ain't no way for a boy to contain the love that he feels inside. So I carved her name into my tree. Then I carved her heart around her name. Then I carved an arrow through the heart, just to say I love you. Now on a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering. I remember the nails through my hands and your name in my heart, and how in their worldless ways the nails explain the love that he feels inside. As they carved your name into my tree, where I wrapped my heart around your name, then I took your arrow through my heart, just to say I love you, just to say I love you. Now I can never forget how much you mean to me, 'cause I will always remember whenever I see. Carve your name into my tree, where I wrap my heart around. Then I took your arrow through my heart, just to say I love you. I really love you, just to say I love you.
Song called My Tree by Chris Rice.
Chris Rice, yeah, one of our heroes.
This is our last song for this this set. Mm-hmm. We're gonna be handing it over to
Miss Lou.
And this last song I want to dedicate it to all the married couples that are tuning in.
Yes.
And also around us.
Yes.
Me and Sharon, we've been married for long enough to know that
15 years. Yeah.
Wow.
Long time, but it doesn't feel so long, so that's good, right?
We've been married long enough to know that not every day is unicorns and rainbows.
Definitely not every day.
Not snow flurries. Yeah. Sharon's favorite snow flurries.
Yes.
Yeah, but I think it's a beautiful journey, and hope this song blesses you and affirms your marriage. Mm.
Of careless words and slamming doors, still ringing in the night. I've taken my side and you've taken yours. We're both wrong and we're both right. Once again, misunderstanding has turned us into enemies. I will forgive you. Will you forgive me? Love and learn. That's what we will do. Love and learn. Through the flood and through the flame, this world will turn and the seasons will change. So there's nothing we can get through as long as we both hold on to the hand of God and each other, and take a lifetime to love and learn. We started our leaving, we know love so well, but through the years we find true love is a story only time can tell. God has made this lifetime yours and mine. Oh, love and learn. That's what we will do. Love and learn. Through the flood and through the flame, this world will turn and the seasons will change. There's nothing we can't get through as long as we both hold on to the hand of God and each other, and take a lifetime to love and learn. So until the day when one of us has to lay the other in the arms of Jesus, I will be with you. What we will do, love and learn, through the flood and through the flame, this world will turn and the seasons will change. There's nothing we can't get through as long as we both hold on to the hand of God and each other, and take a lifetime. Take a lifetime to love and learn.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to Kevin and Sharon. So blessed. And I'm so glad that that is only the first half of the music from you guys. I'm looking forward to the second half. And yeah, it says like, hold on to each other, hold on to the hand of God, and we'll get through the seasons together. Yeah. And I think that's very true also outside of marriage as well. And I would like to take this time to introduce Care Channels International, which is the charity that we are choosing to feature today here on Beacon Live. And before I invite our special guest on, I would like to point all of your attentions to this video so you can find out more about what they do first.
Care Channels International is a non-profit organization working among the poor and marginalized in Asia. Our work began in the Philippines in 2000 and has expanded to Timor-Leste, Indonesia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Thailand, and Malaysia. We engage communities through a variety of education, health, and livelihood programs. With our holistic, innovative, and sustainable initiatives, we seek to empower individuals and families to break free from the cycle of poverty. Education is one of the most crucial tools in bringing about economic mobility and stability. Our education sponsorship programs support children through kindergarten, elementary, and college-level education in order to provide education opportunities to kids who cannot afford it. Computer labs and tuition centers are also set up to provide additional learning opportunities. Care Channels organizes regular medical missions and clinics to provide free medical and dental care to impoverished communities. Doctors, nurses, and other volunteers offer both their medical expertise and a listening ear to bring positive and tangible change to the lives of our beneficiaries. We also organize training in less developed areas for local healthcare workers to grow in their professions. Ultimately, it is our long-term goal to empower communities to develop and sustain their own independent healthcare systems. Care Channel's livelihood programs provide occupational training and work opportunities to empower our beneficiaries. Our hope is that these programs will help to increase independence, stability, and confidence. Throughout these communities, we provide training for craft work, where individuals and families learn skills like fresh flower pasting in order to create unique products that can be sold as a means of income. Our mask-making programs provide supplies for local health education programs, while also creating a space for stable jobs and steady livelihoods. Animal dispersal, farming, and other agricultural projects bring economic opportunities to our beneficiaries in many rural areas. We operate farms that provide employment and offer training in new farming methods. Seed, stock, and animals are distributed to families to raise and sell in their own communities. Micro-business loans are made available to skilled basket weavers, allowing them to sustainably purchase the necessary materials to weave bamboo crafts for sale. Through these various programs, Care Channels partners with individuals, families, and communities to bring sustainable economic opportunity and training across Asia. We thank you for your support, and we welcome you to come alongside our local teams to walk with our beneficiaries in their journeys from dependency to dignity.
I hope you've learned more about what Care Channels International does, what they do, and I am so privileged that we have Sing Ing here from CCI joining us to tell you a little bit more about what they do and, yeah, to share some interesting stories, I hope. How are you, Sing Ing? Welcome.
Well, I'm well. I'm good.
That's wonderful.
Yes, I've been locked down, as you can say, in Singapore for a year and a half now.
Wow, yeah. And knowing that you used to travel a lot before because of your work with CCI, this must have been a huge change for you, right?
Yes. For the last maybe 25 years of my life, I've been on the road quite a bit. As much as 6 months in a year.
Wow.
And so this is the 1.5 years that I've not traveled at all.
Wow. It must be such a drastic change.
It's a good change.
More time with family?
Yes, for sure.
That's wonderful. Yes. Yeah, so tell me a little bit more about the work that you do at CCI.
Well, I'm the executive director and also the founder of CCI. And CCI is basically an NGO that is working among the poor. And we have worked in several different countries.
Wonderful. Yeah. So I know that these several different countries are based in Asia as well. So would you like to tell our viewers about the specific countries that you're in and the kind of work that you've been doing there?
Yeah, we first started in the Philippines in the year 2000, and then followed by coming back to Singapore to set up in about year 2005. And then we then set up in different countries like Pakistan, Indonesia, East Timor, Thailand, and then Bangladesh.
Yeah, wonderful that it covers many different countries. And could you tell us about Care Channels International's mission?
Well, our mission is we work among the needy and especially the marginalized people. And we work through different kinds of programs, particularly in the area of education, in the area of healthcare, and also in the area of livelihood. We believe that it is better to teach the person how to fish than to give him a fish every day.
Yeah, I agree with that. And it's such important work that you're doing. So would you like to tell the viewers any stories that you might have encountered over these past years?
I think one story that constantly captured my mind, really, is the fact that we were doing the press flower calendars for quite a few years. Mm. And this is a livelihood program for the poor living in the slum areas. And I remembered after making them, one of the mothers looked at me and he says, you know, can I buy one of these? Mm. You know, and I looked at her and I says, why did you want to buy one of these and it's not really that cheap for you? And she looked at me and she just said, you know, it's beautiful. And I looked at her and said, yes, I think it's beautiful. It's real pressed flowers. And I asked her, what would you like to do with it? And she says, I would like to pin it up in my home. And every day I looked at it, I can see that this is a handiwork, a portion of my handiwork. And it really touched me to think that, you know, with the little that she has earned, she's willing to invest and to see her handiwork in her own home.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah, I guess to feel that sense of pride to see that and say, I made that.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
And it really is a thing of beauty, the calendars that you have prepared. This is the 2021 calendar.
Yes.
And when I saw it, after running my fingers through, it's like, wow, it's really beautiful because you can feel the textures and to know that someone actually took the time to press every single petal, every single leaf on it. It just feels different from one of those machine-made ones. Yeah.
By all means, yes.
These calendars are definitely available on CCI's website, right?
Yes.
So we'll get to that very soon. But I'd like to ask Xing-Ying, like, how did it begin for you? And was there any particular incident that led to the start of CCI?
Well, I remembered, we can wheel back the clock to 1987. Mm-hmm. I just graduated and worked for 2 years, and there was a kind of a mission trip from my church to go to the Philippines, and I signed up. And so there was a team of us that went, and that particular trip really changed my life in a sense that that was my first time walking up a dump site, a rubbish dump site. And that dump site was about 10 story high. And I was climbing up, and as I was climbing up, it has many flashbacks in my own life. I grew up in a red light district. Mm. I was born in KL. I grew up there, and as was walking up, seeing the different homes, it was like a movie played back to me in my life as I looked back. But it was a very different movie in a sense that I thought my life when I was young was tough. Mm. But I could not imagine how people could live on rubbish itself. Mm. And this incident made me reflect when I came back from that first climb and thought about it. And this trip was also a very special trip for me. And, I also met my wife during this trip.
Wonderful.
Yeah, and we were in the same team. I got to know her. So you can say it was a very painful experience, and yet it was also a very joyful one.
Bittersweet.
Yes, bittersweet. And then, and both of us, we shared quite a bit, and we were thinking how we can help. Mm. And the end of the trip, I had just a simple prayer, and I just prayed that, God, I am open. I don't think I'm yet ready, but I'm open for you to tell me what is the next step.
Wow. And after you prayed that prayer, how did God let you know that the steps would lead to CCI?
Well, every 2 years then, we go back to Philippines to visit. And by the time it came to 1995, there was quite a few trips after that. And in 1995, I decided to quit from my job and decided to spend a year in a Bible school and to prepare myself for the work that I believe God has called me to go there.
Wonderful. It's so wonderful to hear that. And it's also lovely that you met your wife at the beginning of this journey so that she could journey with you as well. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So how many years have you been married?
Well, we are married in 89, so you can say it's 30 over years. Huh?
Wonderful. It's nice to have, you know, the stories of, you know, wonderful married couples here, not just Kevin and Sharon, but you and your wife as well.
Yes.
Yeah, and I'm sure all of that feeds into establishing CCI. So did you start it on your own, or how was the beginning like?
Well, we left Singapore for Philippines in January 1998. Mm. And we spent really the first 2 years just learning Filipino. Mm. About four times a week, each time about 3 hours. And then after that, in the afternoon, we will go to the slums and to the different areas to practice our Filipino. And as we were visiting, we got to know the people better, we got to understand the issues better, we got to connect better. And that has also shaped the way we think about how to help the poor. And then we realized that poverty is quite personal. Each one has a very unique story, why they are there. And we also realized that poverty is also very complex. There is a host of different factors, incidences that leads to where they are. And then as we looked at it, we also realized that poverty is also very structural. Their children will very likely stay where they are.
Right.
Yeah, and very likely they don't go to school. Very likely they get poor health treatment. And they are not skilled enough to get a good job. So there were different kinds of problems as we spent the first 2 years understanding and visiting and hearing the stories. And that has also structured the way we think about how best we can help them. My wife is a medical doctor, and so she handles the health part. I'm the human resource person, so I handle the education part. And we realized that livelihood is very important to put work in the hands and to create dignity.
Wonderful. So you mentioned livelihood, healthcare, as well as education. Could you tell our viewers a little bit more specifically under each, what CCI is doing in the communities that you're reaching out to?
Sure. We are helping kids from the poor areas to go to school. So we have a sponsorship program. And in some areas, we actually start the school. And if there are reasonable government schools around, we will help them go to school, and so we will have an education sponsorship. So we have an education sponsorship that starts from kindergarten all the way to college. And as of today, we have about close to 60 over students in college itself studying even in this time. So all in all, we are putting close to 5,000 over students to school.
Wonderful. It's powerful because it not just changes the students' lives, right? But the families' lives are changed as well. 5,000 over, that's wonderful. Praise God.
So personally, I have seen a kid being sponsored from primary one and seen her graduate from college.
Wow.
So that is about a journey of at least 12 to 15 years. The different programs, the next program we have is in the area of health. My wife being a doctor, so we started medical dental clinics, we started mobile clinics, and we also start quite a bit of health education, especially teaching the families in the slums what is good and nutritious food and also delicious food. And we also have surgical assistance where we see some surgery cases where we sponsor them through. And then we also see a lot of malnourishment cases, children that are malnourished and how to get them out of it. So these are the different kinds of health programs. And we also have livelihood programs where we create jobs. And especially in this COVID season, we created 1,200 jobs for different families.
That's great. Yeah. So tell us a little bit about how COVID-19 has impacted the work that you do and how you reach out to the people without being able to be there.
Well, Care Channels is a lot of ground people. So one of the things that COVID did was it prevented me from traveling there. And it also taught me to learn to have Zoom, learn to have virtual meetings quite a bit.
That's right.
So practically every day I'm in Zoom now with the different countries. And they also have to learn how to Zoom. So we have to put on our headsets, you know, and be able to talk. And We talk about the challenges we face and then how we can overcome them. And they being at the site is able to reach out. And so we talked about what best to do and how to overcome some of the restrictions. And so even despite all of that situation itself, we are still able to send the children to school. So we put them in the different centers, school closed down. So we have virtual classes, online classes. We set up the internet. We talk to the community centers? Could we have different kinds of tutorial groups? Mm. And so those are the interesting things that we do differently in this COVID season. Yeah, and we had a lot of health program. We realized that to prevent COVID, there are really three things that we really must do. One, certain level of social distancing, at least 1 meter. And the second one is really the face mask. And then two, how to wash their hands, either soap or with 70% alcohol.
Yeah. So other than the medium in which you can, how the work is being carried out, how might the pandemic have impacted the beneficiaries and the people who need help?
Well, the first couple of months were very difficult, especially the first 2 or 3 months when the lockdown happens. Mm. And one of the things that caught us by surprise was, as we looked at it, the moment the lockdown happened is many of the poor are daily raided. And because they could not work, they have no pay. And because they have no pay, they have no food. So one of the first programs that we really have to do was to pack food and send to them at least for the first 1 month to 3 months, depending on which area it is. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's something that I'm sure if people want to help out in, they will be able to help out by donating to care channels. Yes.
Yeah.
So should we talk a little bit about the livelihood part and how people can best support care channels?
Yes. You can best support care channels, go to our website and you can see the different kinds of products that are made by the poor. And by you buying them, you're actually providing work for them. Like we have set up honey. We have different honey production sites. Mm. And so this particular area is also one area. If you buy this honey, you'll be helping different families who are harvesting the honey and bottling it up. Yeah.
That's wonderful. And other than honey, there's also other products that I would love to bring up because they're so beautifully made.
Yes.
So this is a cross-stitch card,
yes? This is a cross-stitch card where the family themselves were to make at their home in the slums so that the mother or father itself that made this is able to stay at home and be able to be with the child or wait for the child. And so this is the pressed flower itself. Now, in the slums, you don't have flowers. And so we have to find ways and means to harvest flowers. So we have different families who are in villages or in the rural areas where flowers are grown, and we have to teach them how to collect the flower and how to dry the flower and how to pack the flower and send to the city. And then we will redistribute. So like, for example, this thank you card, all of it is flower, the different kinds of flowers. Yeah.
So if you see it up close, you actually get to see it in 3D, which is beautiful. And I think during this time, right, this almost serves as you kill two birds with one stone, right? Not only do you support the families that are making this their livelihood, but you also can reach out to somebody whom you haven't connected in a while and to really say thank you, because I feel like this time, in this period, a lot of us, we say social distancing, right? We don't see each other physically, but also that social aspect also makes us feel lonelier and things like that. So I think if you want to go just a little bit of the extra mile and to tell somebody thank you or that you're thinking of them, I think this is a great way to do so. Yeah. So go to Care Channels International's website and you'll be able to donate and buy these merchandise. Yeah, to really support them.
Yes.
Is there anything else you would like to tell our viewers?
Yes, you can also support the children and the youth. There are quite many of them today who couldn't go to school. And if you like to sponsor a child, it costs $250 per child per year to put them in school. Mm. Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time, Sing Ing. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for listening.
Now, I'd like to invite Michelle back on, and Sing Ing, you may take your leave. We are going to perform a song that you have chosen, and this is a song called I, Lord of Sea and Sky.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Sky, I have heard.
people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain, and I have wept for love of them. They turn away, but I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. Who will speak my word to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have satisfied. Yes, I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here am I, Lord. And is it I, Lord? For I have fought you, Thank you. That's a song called Here I Am, Lord, and really talks about answering God's call to reach out to the nations and to reach out to the people whom He loves. So at this point, I'd like to invite back our favorite couple of the evening, Kevin and Sharon, to bless us with more CCM. Yay!
We're going to invite Daniel up as well. He's going to join us on a couple of tunes.
Check one, two. It's been a while since we performed, actually, getting back in the groove. A lot of effort is done on my part to get the music right, but I think 50% of the effort is putting the couple in the correct position. Couple four.
So I don't use couple.
Please remind me back at home after that, must take out the couple, if not.
So what's this first song and why do you guys choose this song?
Wow. This is by Chris Tomlin, a song called Everlasting God. I think it's very apt for the season. It's a very unusual place that everybody's in. And I think it talks about waiting upon the Lord, drawing our strength and our dependence on God. Yeah, I think that's I think the biggest takeaway that we have this current season.
Yeah. Mm. Thank you.
Rise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength arise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever, our hope, our strong as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength to rise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait. Comfort those in need. just upon wings like eagles. Amen.
Thank you so much for that. You know, I think most of the songs actually you guys have done today I've never heard before. So it's great, you know, to learn new songs. So maybe before we let them carry on, I'm just going to jump into the comments. And we have Bernard here. Hi, Bernard. It says, beautiful singing. Here I am, Lord. I guess these are the older comments. Let's see.
Bernard is my friend, I think.
Yes, Bernard.
Yeah, yeah. I posted 2 days ago, and yesterday night, he was like, hey, Kevin, 8 o'clock already. Oops.
Thank you.
He thought you forgot.
That's great support.
But you're here tonight.
Yeah, we have Hilda. Nice to see you, Hilda. And Min is here as well. And let's see. All right, so we're going to let you guys carry on and I'll join you guys in a few songs time as well.
Thank you.
I want to leave you all with a reminder and an assurance that in any season, in any situation, we have a God who does not change, who is the same, who is our constant. His love is steadfast, and we know a God that is faithful and true. Just like the sunshine, you have been
treasure, a portion with
Constant, he's steadfast, he's faithful and true. Amen.
Amen. And so we say as Christians in the song just now, that was by Charlie Hall. We say, Jesus, you are here with us, constantly here with us, and you are our everything, faithful and true. And this faithfulness actually has been our kind of like motto, you know, like great is thy faithfulness, oh God, is our motto in our marriage.
That's our wedding song.
Yeah, it was. I don't know why. Somehow we were prompted to choose that as our wedding song, and don't know how come it's like our anthem. So in every situation, somehow we come back to this, you know. But I also know that, you know, it's easy for us sometimes as Christians to say, oh, God is faithful and you know, constant and. Sometimes it's just hard, right? It's just hard to see this. But I want to say that, you know, sometimes we can't see the light. We can't see Jesus the light because we're expecting to find it in certain places that we're always used to finding it. But he might surprise you because he's actually always there. We just have to see it, you know, in the places that are unexpected. And I also want to say that if today you have difficulty, you know, believing this, if you have difficulty finding the light, it doesn't matter, Christian, not Christian, it doesn't matter, but in whatever circumstance you're in, if you can't believe it, it's okay, because, you know, we, as community, we believe it for you. And so this next song is for you if you're in any difficult circumstance and you can't see, and we hope it will give you some semblance of comfort.
These are the places I was so sure I'd find him. I've looked in the pages and I looked down on my knees. I've lifted my eyes in expectation to see the sun still refusing to shine. Sometimes he comes in the clouds. Sometimes his face cannot be found. Sometimes the sky is dark and gray. Some things can only be known, but sometimes our faith can only grow when we can't see. Sometimes he comes in the sometimes I see me a sailor out on the ocean, so brave and so sure, as long as skies are clear. But when the clouds start to gather, I watch my faith turn to fear. Sometimes he comes in the clouds. Sometimes his face cannot be found. Sometimes the sky is dark and gray. But some things can only be known. Sometimes our faith can only grow when we can't see. Sometimes he comes in the rain, and we question the pain,
why God can seem so far away. Time will show us He was right there with us. Sometimes He comes in the clouds. Sometimes His face cannot be found. Sometimes the sky is dark and gray. Some things can only be known. Sometimes our faith can only grow when we can't see. Sometimes He comes in the cloud. He comes in the cloud.
Thank you. Song by Stephen Curtis Chapman. Sometimes He Comes in the Clouds. Yes. Hope it spoke to you.
Yeah. One of his older songs, yeah?
Yeah.
Written when he was very young. For our next song, we're going to invite Daniel up.
Was I the only one to notice that human nature doesn't work that way? They tell me if I look deep inside me that I can find my own way. I only find a rebel and a fool who won't admit that he's afraid. I thought I was holding on to freedom, but locked my soul up in chains. I need a hero who dared to find me. Fly to my rescue and crash through the wall. Announce my freedom. Bring me to my senses. Gather me into strong arms and carry me safety. What is this talk about a savior? Does he listen? Is he even there? Should I be asking him directly? Why should he consider my prayer? Well, I don't quite know how to do this. Jesus, I can save myself. So here I go, calling out for mercy and crying out for your help. So if you hear me, I need a hero who dared to find me. Fly to my rescue. Through the walls, announce my freedom. Bring me to my the walls. Announce my freedom. Bring me to my senses. Gather me into strong arms and carry me off to his safety. Thank you. Song called I Need a Hero by Chris Rice. Thank you, Daniel.
Yeah, thank you. And I think now might be a good time if maybe we can chat a bit more about a project you guys have embarked on, and this is called Project Sending Love,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So maybe you can share with everyone more about this.
Yeah, it was a little project of ours that we started just, I think, 3 weeks ago? Something like that, I think it all started when I was posed two questions, actually, this project. Mm. Justice and mercy. These two topics are very, very strangely new to me. Yeah, not really new. I've heard it all my life. Mm. But I think I am the expert at dodging these two these two topics, justice and mercy, because, yeah, I don't know what to do with it. Yeah, so I would just not have anything to do with it. Maybe I feel like it's because I'm not influential enough, or I don't have that position or power to affect anything. Mm. Yeah, so all my life I've heard about it, but it's just very little done about it. Recently in church, there were two questions posed to me. What do you feel that is unfair in the world? Mm. And second question is, what are you going to do about it? What have you done about it? Yeah, so I answered the first question, what is unfair? What do I feel unfair? First thing that came to my mind was me and Sharon going for our
vaccinations.
Needles are a scary thing for me, but I think the whole experience was just so easy and
so pleasant.
So pleasant, actually. Yeah. There was like ushers.
Except for Michelle.
Michelle, second jet would be better. It was really a very smooth experience. We really had it easy, and there was, I think, like any single time, three people taking care of you or something like that.
Mm. We even had presents, I think. We
gifts,
you know. Did you get?
Can take masks, lah.
It was amazing.
Mm. Only thing missing is no Milo,
no Milo.
And no Ribena.
So, carry on. Yeah.
Well, I went back home and, you know, you watch the news on CNN and you see India. Yeah, India was particularly heartbreaking for me, because it's like a war zone. So many people suffering, and except that they're not in war, you know. Yeah, you see the open area and the dead bodies there. You read about them out of fear or not knowing what to do. They throw the dead bodies in the river.
Mm.
It's just the whole situation that things that they do not have, the oxygen canisters, the vaccine, the vaccination.
The beds, beds in the hospital.
Yeah.
And on the flip side, you know, we just walk through the community center and we have it like a VIP. Mm. So I answered that question, and that was unfair to me. Yeah. So second question was, what are you going to do about it? What have you done about it? And me being the expert at question number two, I said, no, not going to do about it. All my life. Yeah, it's just a very easy question to answer. To a point where, you know, after answering, I went back home and I had sleepless night number one, sleepless night number two. I had a few sleepless nights. Yeah, because I think I couldn't reconcile the fact that I know about the situation where there's suffering and pain and hopelessness, and I'm in a position where I choose not to do anything about it. Yeah, so that I cannot reconcile, and that does not match, lah. So after a few sleepless nights, one morning I woke up and I decided to do something about it. Yeah, it was just a very wide and big idea.
Sleepless nights in the Bible is actually God telling you something. Remember?
Yeah.
first person I approached was Sharon eating her breakfast. I'm going to do a fundraiser for India. You wanna join me? And she's like,
hey.
Sharon very on about going on live stream with me.
Wow, that's great. So you guys had your first live stream last week, right?
Yeah, correct. That was the launch of our Sending Love project.
you want to share how people can support this project?
Yeah. So I think what you can do is you can take a look at the comments or
it's
there already. We got a giving.sg page up. We are partnering with the Red Cross, so you can.
We chose to do that because it's just easier to help like raise funds for a large enough organization so that they can cut through all the red tape and do the things like really efficiently rather than do it ourselves. So we had a bake sale. But I mean orders are now closed, but you can still donate to giving.sg. And every little bit counts. So don't think that you have nothing much to give. Every little bit counts.
Yeah. That's great. And we were one of the beneficiaries of the lovely sourdough bread that Sharon baked. So maybe Sharon might bring it back if there's enough demand. You guys can check out in the comments down below. We have both the giving.sg link as well as their Facebook page, Project Sending Love. Do follow the page and please consider contributing to this wonderful cause. And thank you so much. And it was great that it just coincided with this chance for you guys to share about it. And that's really nice.
Also, for Sending Love, right? I mean, we're hoping that we can continue to support other causes. So if you feel that you want to contribute, whether it's you have a skill that you want to contribute, whether it's baking or crafting or anything, do drop us a note in the Facebook page, because later on when we have more projects, we can contact you and we can work together.
That's amazing. I don't think there will ever be a end to needing to send love to different places. So that's amazing. Hopefully you guys can keep this going. And thank you so much for sharing about that. And I think you guys have one last song for us. Okay, maybe you can share about that.
I'm going to close tonight. This is our last song. It's called A Life Means So Much. I think a lot of the time, a lot of the things that we've been given, we've been taken for granted, we are always in a privileged position to be able to give. And basically, just loving our neighbor.
Yes.
Spend, will you invest or squander? Try to get ahead or help someone who's under. Teach us to count the days. Teach us to make the days count. Lead us in better ways. Somehow our souls forgot. Life means so much. Life means so much. Life means so much. Does anybody live to know the value of life? It didn't even give us all to show the worth of yours and mine. Teach us to count the days. Teach us to make the days count. Lead us in better ways. Somehow our souls were God. Life means so much. Life means so much. Life means so much.
You've been given me the bones of the light. I've been ready to live so and every much. Day is a gift. You've life been given me the bones so of the light.
Thank you so much to Kevin and Sharon. I loved all the songs that you guys have picked. And thank you for introducing me to Chris Rice. Because
yes.
I really love the way he writes. The lyrics, the musical, the chord progression choices are just insane.
When you listen to him, use headphones because there's a lot of nuances inside.
Yes, and even
amazing.
The way he pens stuff, just
very,
so
very
powerful.
Nice.
So
yes.
Geeking out on music stuff, but I think the message is still really, really powerful and how he really glorifies God and points people to God in the end and to hope. I think that's the most important thing beyond the music excellence and
the
songwriting. Yeah, the cleverness of it, the heart is in the right place.
Right.
So that goes the same with you guys. Thank you for blessing all of us with the music tonight as well as your stories and for also working so hard on the Sending Love project. And yeah, we wish you all the best. Thank you so much for being here on Beacon Live.
Thanks for having us.
No problem at all.
We really enjoyed it because it's been so long since we played these songs.
Yay! Wonderful. Thank you so much. And I would like to say to all our viewers, usually we do once every 2 weeks, but we are going to have a special episode next week in anticipation of Father's Day. Yeah. So we are going to see you next week, 15th June. And yes, take care. God bless. Good night and goodbye.